Good evening. I'm Phoenix. Welcome to Minor Peace Theater. Tonight, we begin a new series called I Creatively Procrastinate from the NaNoWriMo Challenge, in which I am enrolled this month, through taking part in a little bit of literary nonsense with all of you. I will run over 4 weekly episodes, and during each episode, I will share a piece of flash fiction I composed in the week of your prompt, instead of writing the novel I should have been working on. So please, fill your glass with whichever suits your fancy. Pull up a comfortable chair as we settle into our evening together. Hello to whoever is out there. Hello, Allie. Thank you. Yes, I quite enjoy my pipe. It makes little whistling sounds. I wish you could hear it. It is very, very nice. I just wish that maybe it could be filled with bubbles. Perhaps we can figure out how to do that another time. So as I said, in these episodes, I will be using them as a creative procrastination technique. As you know, to all of us artists, whether we be writers or painters or sketchers or whatever else we may want to be, procrastination is itself an art form and must be practiced if we are to do it to its perfection. All right, now, once again, let's see. Brittany, hello. Allie, hello. I do not know who else is watching. Leave me a hello in the comments and I will get to you. In a few minutes, I will read to you the piece of flash fiction that I composed this week, as I said, instead of doing what I was supposed to do on the novel I was supposed to be writing. I composed this piece of flash fiction based on a prompt that our dear Miss Stabby gave me last weekend. But before I begin, I will be asking all of you for a little bit of help. I need a prompt for next week. The prompt challenge that I have set out for you to help me with is in the comments of the post that announced today's event. It starts out using predictive text or your imagination, whichever you feel would be better to be used. When I woke up this morning, I had no idea I would find blank. Some of you have already written your answer. That is fantastic. I will put your names into a draw and I will pull out one. And that will be the prompt that I will write. If you want to throw any of them into the comments right now, please do so. If you want to look at that other post, please do so as well. Now, without any further ado, let me read the bit of flash fiction, the creative procrastination that kept me from my novel in the most wonderful ways. There it was. The click, click, click of heels across a tiled floor following me. Except I was outside on pavement with an inch of snow crunching beneath my speakers. My sneakers, not my speakers. That would be very interesting if it was crunching underneath my speakers. I would think that there was maybe something very, very wrong with those speakers. I inched my chin deeper into the collar of my coat and regretted, not for the first time that evening, my early morning decision that left me walking home from work instead of taking the car. Blowing a frosted breath into my cupped hands, I scanned the empty street. Daylight savings had come and gone, and already the shadows were gathering. I jumped as the street lights buzzed and turned on, casting isolated pools of light along the darkened road. Realizing I wasn't getting any warmer standing alone on the sidewalk, I drew a deep breath and continued forward. Sure enough, within few steps, I heard it again. Click, click, click. I reached the closest ring of light in half the steps it normally would have taken me, and fumbled my frozen fingers into my pockets for my phone, only to find them empty. My heart sank. I must have left it back at the office. I swallowed, turning slowly, searching the shadows behind me. "Hello?" I called, realizing as soon as a word left my lips how futile it was. What was I expecting? Someone to answer back. Silence. Uncanny silence. There should have at least been a dull rumble of engines from the other side of the park. But I heard nothing besides the sound of my own breath sending tendrils of frost into the night. Indecision took hold. I looked once more down at the empty street before me. All I had to do was get to the next street lamp. I could do that. With the speed of a child launching themselves out of bed to use a toilet in the middle of the night, I shouldered my backpack and ran. The click, click, click kept pace with each step, gaining, and then I tore my bag from my back, stumbling into a lit pool and brandishing it in front of me. Earbuds yanked from my ears, surprising me enough to pause the flood of panic as I finally, frantically, followed the cord to an outer pocket where, within the mesh that usually held my water bottle, my cell phone nested. I grabbed it, thumbing the screen in my haste to wrench the earbuds free from the jack, and turned it over just in time to see Naomi Aimone fall apart in my hands as Gloria Gaynor's voice trailed into the evening. At first, I was afraid. I was petrified. Until I realized what I'd done before I went outside. A laugh puffed out and I shook my head, glancing quickly up and down the empty street as a wave of embarrassed relief slowly washed away the adrenaline. My pulse slowed, and I made a mental note to re-engage my accidental touch protection. As I replaced my earbuds, pressed play, and sashayed the rest of the way home. So that was my first installment, my very first piece of Minor Peace Theater. I hope you enjoyed it, my little bit of flash fiction, my little procrastination attempt to keep from writing the novel that I should be writing today. I am looking forward to next week, sharing with you episode 2, a new piece of flash fiction that I will use in my quest to perfect the art of procrastination that all artists must perfect at some point. If you wish for your piece of flash fiction to be written from the prompt that I have given you in the post that announced today, please write the sentence. Finish the sentence using predictive text or your imagination, whichever you would prefer. I never thought I would wake up this morning and find. Thank you very much. You have been wonderful. I will see you next week.